I just popped a bean yesterday, it was a long night. I didn't did the right drugs, only on the wrong night. I was rocking off white, trying to have a
scene of a house fire right now in Duncansville, Blair County. Our Colleen Knutson is live for us today at that scene. Let's check in with her. Colleen, what can you tell us at this point?
Well, Casey, as you can see behind me, fire crews are still actively working to control this fire. And because of that, I haven't been able to talk with a fire official about what exactly happened, but I was able to speak to a family member of the homeowner. Six crews responded to the call of a fire between 10:30 and 10:45 this morning. The family member tells me her cousin was home at the time the fire started. She says it started in the basement of the home, but her cousin was able to get out on his own. The house is on White Oak Lane in Duncansville. It's actually on a dirt road off of the main stretch of Mill Road. Fire trucks were unable to make it all the way back to the house, so water tankers had to be brought in. We're told the house owner does not have homeowner's insurance and has been without a job for the past 3 years. Allegheny Township Volunteer Fire Department is taking lead here today. And again, we haven't been able to catch up with anyone from the department because they have been working on trying to contain the fire and completely extinguish it. But we will bring you more information as it becomes available. But one firefighter says that they're going to be working here for a while. For now, in Duncansville, I'm Colleen Knutson, WTAJ News.
Yeah, it certainly looks like that. Colleen, still a very active situation there behind you. Thank you for that.
Yes, I'm Amanda Kenny. The state police fire marshal is investigating what caused a Blair County apartment to go up in flames. No residents were injured, but 12 families are without a home tonight. Fire crews worked into the evening Friday on a four-alarm fire that ripped through Country Club Terrace in Hollidaysburg. The fire started around 1 o'clock when most residents were at work, but some were home.
Some of the tenants here helped me get other tenants out of the building. You know, did a really good job.
There are 24 apartments affected by the blaze, but the 12 in building 4B were destroyed. Firefighters helped residents collect as many items as they could.
We got all of them in that they could get whatever they want out of the building because nothing in that side is affected. It was all on the 4B side. So if we could get it out, we went in and we assisted them in getting stuff out of the building.
The Red Cross quickly arrived on scene, hoping to help those displaced by the fire.
We provide direct financial assistance so that they can go buy what they need for the first couple of days after a fire, so they can go buy food if they need, they can go buy clothes, medications, whatever it might be that they need to get through the first couple of days.
Fire crews got it under control in 2 hours, but water was an issue. There were no sprinklers inside the building because it was built before the code requirement, and nearby fire hydrants had low pressure. Crews were pulled back until 4 water tankers arrived, then spent almost 4 hours putting out hot spots on the roof. 2 firefighters were injured, but were treated at the scene.
Fire companies here, all of them did a great job. They did a really good
job. Big money on me, nigga, I'ma run it up, 'cause I remember I was broken.